TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening, welcome to South Asia Newsline. I am Uzma Jafri. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 13th of December. India-Maldives exchanged 3 agreements to boost bilateral ties. Khalilzad announces brief pause in US-Taliban talks. And migratory birds flock to Indian city with onset of winter. And now for all the details. India paid homage to the victims of 2001 Parliament attack on its 18th anniversary on Friday. On this day, 18 years ago, terrorists of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed attacked the Indian Parliament complex, killing 9 people.
India paid homage to the victims of 2001 Parliament attacks on its 18th anniversary on Friday. Led by Indian Vice President Venkaiah Naidu and Prime Minister Narendra Modi, members of the Parliament paid floral tributes to those killed in the attack at a memorial in the Parliament premises. Former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh and Indian Interior Minister Amit Shah were among others who paid floral tributes to the victims. On December 13, 2001, 5 militants stormed the Parliament complex in New Delhi, armed with grenades, guns and explosives, but security forces killed them before they could enter the main chamber. 14 people, including 5 militants, 6 security personnel and 3 government staff died in the militant attack. New Delhi said the attackers belonged to Pakistan-based Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Taiba militant groups. Pakistan denied any involvement and condemned the attack.
India and Maldives exchanged 3 agreements to boost bilateral cooperation after a high-level meeting between the foreign ministers of the 2 countries in New Delhi on Friday. The Maldivian foreign minister also called on Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi later in the day.
Maldivian Foreign Minister Abdullah Shahid met his Indian counterpart S. Jaishankar in Indian capital New Delhi on Friday to further enhance ties. The two leaders co-chaired the 6th India-Maldives Joint Commission meeting, or JCM, and reviewed the entire gamut of a vast and expanding bilateral relationship between the 2 countries. The high-level meeting between India and Maldives took place after a gap of 4 years. After the meeting, the 2 leaders signed and witnessed exchange of 3 agreements, which include MOUs for cooperation between the election commissions, financial intelligence units, and an instrument of ratification for the Treaty on Mutual Legal Assistance in Criminal Matters. Shahid's visit came days after India handed over a patrol vessel to the Maldives National Defence Force in an event which also saw inauguration of 4 key development projects in the archipelago covering a wide range of sectors.
In news from Pakistan, Pakistan's Interior Minister Ejaz Shah has said that the legal requirements in the treason case against former President Parvez Musharraf have not been completed. Shah said Musharraf should be given a fair chance during his trial, during which he can produce witnesses in his defense.
Pakistan's Interior Minister Ejaz Shah has said that the legal requirements have not been completed in the treason case against former President Parvez Musharraf. Shah, in an interview to a local media outlet on Thursday, said the government believes that Musharraf should be given a fair chance during the treason trial and that there should be a proper prosecution in which he should be allowed to produce witnesses in his defense. A special court in Pakistan, which has been taking up Musharraf's trial since 2013, has said that it will announce its verdict on December 17 after hearing the arguments of the new prosecution team appointed by the government. Former military ruler Parvez Musharraf last week had called the high treason case against him baseless and showed mistrust in the judicial process, saying he's not been heard. He is currently admitted to a hospital in Dubai because of his ailing health.
Moving on, the illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan continues to grapple with collapsing education sector and unemployment for years due to a failed administration. Locals have expressed that unemployment is on rise and highly educated youth are forced to take odd jobs for survival.
The illegally occupied region of Gilgit-Baltistan has been grappling with collapsing education sector, rising poverty and unemployment for years due to a failed administration. Pakistan's illegal occupation for decades has pushed the region into the most neglected, backward and poorest area in South Asia. Residents say that Pakistan has turned a blind eye to the harsh realities and they are forced to fend for themselves. Unemployment has become a major challenge in Gilgit-Baltistan and those highly educated are either unemployed or have to take up small or odd jobs.
तो यहाँ के लोकल जो मुलाजमी हैं लोग हैं डिग्रियां बगलों में लेके ज्यादा से ज्यादा हो या तो वो एलडीसी में जाते हैं या यूडीसी में जाते हैं और इवन देन यहाँ पर जुल्म इतना है कि वो चपरासी की नौकरी तक जाते और मैट्रिक और इंटर वाले तो फुटपाथ में ही है ये इतना सबसे बड़ा जुल्म है.
Residents said that they do not benefit from multi-billion dollar China-Pakistan Economic Corridor or CPEC project that passes through Gilgit-Baltistan.
इस तरह ये इलाका दिन ब दिन तबाह होता जाएगा यहाँ की तारीख यहाँ की सकाफत को बचाने के लिए कौम को इकट्ठा होने की जरूरत है अदरवाइज गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान तारीख से गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान की जो तारीख है वो मिटती जाएगी दुनिया के नक्शे से आजकल चाइना से जो सीपेक की बात हो रही है सीपेक गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान से निकल रहा लेकिन गिलगित-बल्तिस्तान के बारे में यहाँ पर कोई प्रोजेक्ट नहीं है.
Activists have long blamed that CPEC is illegal and that the indigenous people of Gilgit-Baltistan have been stripped away of their natural resources and have been forced to accept it without any compensation in return.
News just in. A roadside bomb blast in Afghanistan's central Ghazni province killed at least 10 civilians and wounded several on Friday. Presidential spokesperson Sadiq Siddiqui confirmed the casualties in a tweet and blamed the Taliban for the blast while condemning the attack. Meanwhile, the new round of US-Taliban negotiations in Doha, which began earlier this month, have been paused after the Taliban fighters launched an intense attack at a key US military base in Afghanistan this week.
U.S. Special Envoy for Afghanistan Zalmay Khalilzad said on Friday his team was taking a brief pause from talks with the Taliban after an attack at Bagram Air Base, a key U.S. base in Afghanistan, this week. Taking to Twitter, Khalilzad said, "I met Talibs today. I expressed outrage about attack on Bagram," adding, "We are taking a brief pause for them to consult their leadership on this essential topic." The break in the talks was also confirmed by Taliban spokesman Suhail Shaheen, who in a tweet said that the talks will resume after a few days. US diplomat Khalilzad had renewed talks with Taliban negotiators, which began on December 7, on steps that could lead to a ceasefire and a settlement of the 18-year-long war in Afghanistan. But Taliban suicide bombers targeted US military base on Wednesday that killed two civilians and wounded dozens. The attack came days after peace talks between the Taliban and the US negotiators were underway in Doha. The earlier negotiations between the two sides had been called off by US President Donald Trump over the repeated attacks by the group.
In a defiant closing address to the UN's highest tribunal, Myanmar leader Aung San Suu Kyi has pleaded with the judges to dismiss allegations that her country has committed genocide. She urged them to instead allow the country's court-martial system to deal with any human rights abuses.
Myanmar leader Aung San Suu Kyi called on World Court judges on Thursday to dismiss an accusation of genocide against the country's Rohingya Muslim minority and instead urged him to allow the country's court-martial system to deal with any human rights abuses. Suu Kyi was speaking on the third and final day of hearings in The Hague in the Netherlands. Gambia has accused Myanmar of violating the 1948 Genocide Convention in a military campaign that expelled thousands of Rohingya from Myanmar. But Suu Kyi, who has denied genocide, said the UN court should not have jurisdiction.
Myanmar requests the court to remove the case from its list. In the alternative, to reject the request for the indication of provisional measures submitted by the Gambia.
Silence. Meanwhile, presiding judge Abdul Qawi Yusuf said the 17-judge panel would render an order as soon as possible, but gave no specific date. Gambia had earlier insisted that Myanmar could not be trusted to hold its soldiers accountable for alleged atrocities against Rohingyas. More than 730,000 Rohingya fled Myanmar to Bangladesh after the military launched its crackdown in 2017 in Rakhine province. Myanmar, a mainly Buddhist country, considers them illegal immigrants and denies them citizenship.
Migratory birds from Europe and Australia have arrived in western India with the onset of winter season. The winged visitors flock to several parts of the country during winters and settle until the winter season ends.
A huge flock of migratory birds has arrived in Surat city of India's western Gujarat province to spend their winters in the country. The birds from Europe and Australia have become an attraction for many locals who can be seen feeding them while clicking photographs of the winged visitors. Birds belonging to different species flock in parts of India during winters. They settle near water bodies and on trees until the winter season ends.
2000 ke upar se ye bird hai. Gujarati mein ise bolte hai domda, domdo, domdi. English mein inka naam hai gull. Yahan do prakar ke gull hai, brown headed gull, black headed gull. Ye aate hai purva Europe se aur Australia se.
Ye jo seagulls hai wo Australia se aate hai. To wahan ke birds ko yahan फोटोग्राफी करने का चांस हमको मिल जाता है तो बहुत अच्छा लगता है.
From early November onwards, the migratory birds keep arriving in India till December and return during the spring season.
With a hope to bring order to the chaotic roads in India's southern Bengaluru city, authorities have placed life-size mannequins dressed like cops, confusing commuters into thinking that real traffic cops are keeping an eye on them. The move seems to be working, with several bike riders admitting they now wear helmets and stop at red lights after noticing the dummies.
Police in India's southern Bengaluru have found a quirky new way to tackle road traffic offenders in the city. The authorities have placed life-size mannequins which are dressed in police caps, white shirts and brown trousers at congested junctions. A senior police official said the idea was to confuse commuters into thinking that real traffic cops were keeping an eye on them.
They will see the mannequins at a distance. They will discipline themselves. But when they come near the mannequins, they realize, oh, this is a mannequin, that they are fooled and all. Next day, they will try to violate because they think that it is mannequin only. But we will replace these mannequins with our police constables or police officers.
Anywhere going first time, we are properly, we are driving after seeing this.
The move by the traffic police seems to be working, with several bike riders admitting they now wear helmets and stop at red lights after noticing the dummy cops. However, there are some who find the scheme rather amusing, taking selfies with the new local law enforcement.
Well, that's the way it was in South Asia this evening. Before we conclude, the top stories once again. India-Maldives exchanged 3 agreements to boost bilateral ties. Khalilzad announces brief pause in US-Taliban talks. And migratory birds flock to Indian city with onset of winter. Now our viewers can watch the show on SouthAsiaNewsline.com. You can also visit us on Facebook.com/SAsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter @SAsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.